the key is what he just said there. It's mindset, staying in the present.
Yuto Kitsuragawa, the 24-year-old from Japan, just off the green here.
Finds it.
Worth another look right at you.
Gives you an idea of the contours we were talking about there with the tee shot.
It's way up in the air, but it's on a great line if it's the right club.
A bit like Fleetwood's. Don't know if it's going to catch the second ridge, but there's one thing for certain. That wind is starting to blow a little bit. We didn't see that all morning long. That's the most wind we've seen so far
today. It has picked up. You're exactly right. Move on. Rom for birdie at 9.
Difficult par 3. That flag stick is in the dead middle of the green near the back. That's a good shot right there. A real good shot. Jordan Smith hit it to 3 feet 4 inches, and I think that could be inside it. The leader and the closest to the pin here at 11. So what a round for Tommy Fleetwood.
Oh, now this one breaks a lot more off the left than players have been reading so far. Munoz has given it plenty. Has he got the speed? He certainly does. Beautiful shot there. One red.
John Rahm on the tee at 11. Perfect for his shot shape. This looks good. Yes, it is. Will it climb? Yep. Not as good as we saw Tommy Fleetwood, but very acceptable. About it. Yeah. So the U.S. Open champion from 2 years ago at Torrey Pines, far back, but he's got a great round going today. Such a positive stroke.
From 73 yards.
He's normally Daniel Dart. Let's see what he's got here. Oh, he certainly is. That's his forte. He played there. Awesome Henley.
I'll tell you, that front bunker in the middle of the green, that's a tough up and down. This one going right up the gut on that left side.
Is he going to get the bounce? Is he going to get on the green? Only 6 have done it so far this week, and you can now make it 7. Tommy Fleetwood just continuing his assault here at LACC. And we just saw the smile from Tommy, and here's why. Look at that. Yeah, go ahead.
Maybe to the left at the end, depending on how the speed is.
First eagle putt on this hole this weekend for Fleetwood. Did he get it? He did! Fleetwood to 6 under and 4 back.
Eagle scout, you had the call with Scheffler and the hole out yesterday.
Come on. From above, watch the crowd. Yes.
A great.
This will be a fun hole. There's been an eagle here made by Tommy Fleetwood earlier.
Oh, nearly another one.
Oh. You better be precise if you lay up. That's a narrow area. It's one of the wider areas.
So now how's this first birdie? 3. High hopes for Morikawa coming in here. Was playing well. Nice birdie there. But it's just a little too far back. 2-time major champion. 2-11. The tough par 3. Keith Mitchell got it on the green, so he had a long putt for birdie. And the rare birdie by Keith Mitchell at the 11th.
Up
the right side, turning over very high. Good looking tee shot here amongst blue skies for the first time all days, guys. That marine fog, marine layer seems to be lifting.
Yeah, we thought it might lift just about the time the last few groups went off, so we'll see if it can sustain it. In the meantime, McIlroy's banged another huge drive down the left side.
Took full advantage of the right to left wind.
As we go to Sergio over at 17.
Well, this is that popular spot. We saw Austin Ekro chip from back here. Now Garcia. And he makes birdie. Only the second birdie here on 17, and he birdied 16.
Now a big force on the PGA Tour champions.
Well, you could see one of the leaders drive it in that bunker. This is what they'll face.
Harrington earning his spot in here by winning the U.S. Senior Open Championship last year.
Got a little up and under. This is up and right, headed down to the right rough. Little baby cut, trying to hold up the wind. Gonna need a straight kick, but it should hold the fairway.
He can flat out send it too, Zane.
You know, he's the only guy that's really committed to playing a fade. Historically, faders do really well in U.S. Opens. He's also statistically.
Looking good. Didn't quite make the break, but it'll be a two-putt birdie, and McIlroy has birdied the first hole all four rounds. As he begins this final round of the U.S. Open, inside the top seven for the fifth consecutive year, but he's only broken par once in the previous four final rounds. So will this be McIlroy's day?
This hole's still very inaccessible. Exactly what he's done, Zing.
Yeah, that's good thinking. Really, there's nothing else you could do. He's got a chance now to make a birdie. Very fast putt. Good contact here for Rickie. Three full swings so far.
Already 21 birdies in the first 3 days for Fowler. Unbelievable pace. It's not going to happen here, but we'll tell you how big that'll be when he.
Slow direction. Yeah, that's right. See what, how this turns out.
It's great speed there, and that is all that's left for an opening birdie for Clark. Beautiful birdie at 18 to finish up last night, and so birdie last couple of holes for him. He bogeyed the 17th last night when it looked like that was going to be a double. Fleetwood coming home. This was just earlier, his second at the 18th from 212. He is 7 under on the day.
Oh my goodness, look at this.
And all that was left for another 62 in a U.S. Open. For another U.S. Open, part of the record here at the North Course. Oh, pushed it.
Heartbreaking for him.
Kind of like Shinnecock. He had an excellent chance.
Go, go! Good ball. Oh, indeed.
All right, Rick!
Yeah.
judge that. Nearly made it from nearly 60 feet.
There's the rise right here. It's got to crest that with some speed, and it hasn't happened. How about both players using the same putter with the exact same specs in the last group of the U.S. Open? That's pretty nice.
It's a bogey for Clark. All right, here's Fowler.
Got to keep the speed up.
He kept the speed up.
That's going to go off the green. No, that's a good break. Tremendous to be able to keep it from going over.
Those matching putters then able to save par at the second. So both Fowler and Clark take a step back. And this was just earlier from 89 yards.
This will be a sign of things to come. Most of the players will hit from about the same spot.
And Morikawa has been on fire. He started off with five straight pars. Then he birdied three of the last four holes.
Birdies are out there for the leaders.
Yes, Morikawa. Here's Tom Kim's second shot. You never know what you're going to get off of that tee shot, whether you try to lay up or not. Looks like a decent clean line. He's got a good look at it. He skips it over up to the green surface and turn it out really nicely for a birdie for Tom Kim. And he ended up doing that, getting to four under. This hole's been one of the tougher ones out here on the north course.
It was the hardest hole yesterday with a hole cut in the front.
No problem for Xander. Bogeyed the second. Clark over his second shot.
Yeah, from 84 yards. Found a nice clean lie here. 79 to the front, about a half a club uphill.
Spin a little. It didn't have quite enough spin. We know already how quick that's going to be. Back here at three, Fowler, only 68 yards. Let's see if he can spin it from that distance. A little bit, not enough. Boy, he's gonna. Rickie Fowler for birdie to try to get back to 10 under.
He's been more tentative today on the greens, Kurt, the first three putts.
That one I'll give him Wyndham Clark after seeing Fowler's putt. Got a chance. Oh, it wiggled back to the left at the end.
It's the same thing Scheffler's putt did.
Yeah, he said he really wanted to birdie that last hole. Just cleaning up here for his par. Typically a very good putter. Dan talked about that putter change. That's a putter that Rickie Fowler was using. And McIlroy tackling this 480-yard par four. He's birdied at two of the three previous days.
This hole played really difficult yesterday. Not so much today.
Just bounces off that slope, Zing, and just caroms into that right rough. And that one doesn't look great. Get a report on that.
That's exactly what he did, up the left side. Using that terrain, good spot to play from there.
Yeah, that actually was a very controlled swing to a specific spot up there on the left side. That's very good.
Very pure fruit through that fairway cut.
He's hit two brilliant lags so far.
Almost pulled it from off the green. He got to chuckle himself out of it.
Feel on these long putts today for Rory McIlroy.
Oh man, I had a good chance. Just a little too much speed.
Caught some flag stick. Might have ricocheted out of there.
Back on the tee.
Zing, I bet he's the only player in the field not using a tee on the par threes.
Beautiful high cut, working its way toward the hole. If it gets back there, it'll be nice.
Oh my, wow.
that's going to hurt tee sales in the future. I'm going to try without a tee, but what a shot there.
And the handle points at that spot the entire time.
Clark after the best shot of the day, second birdie of the day. That went in with some authority.
Yeah, he's going out to the right. He's trying to drive this.
Cut.
On the front edge. He's going for this every day.
They're asking for it to cut a little bit. And that totally throw the line. And that just didn't cut enough. It just dumps into that really heavy stuff.
He's going out to the left.
Yep, this is a definite layup, and this should be just fine, setting up a short second.
He's got to get back on track, saying he is plus three in the last six holes, going back to that 3.5 foot miss on the 18th last night.
Well, he's made a decision here to trust his wedge game. You know, this is a part of his game where Rickie excels.
While he looks that over, we head back to the short par four. Fowler is well back here.
Yeah, sending it from 98, need a precise number here. Not able to generate any spin from that distance.
On the 12th hole from behind the green.
Well, that is so good right there.
That is really good. No.
It is mojo going if he can make this putt here.
See if he can pay it off here. Not much break in this.
Clark 12 under par in the final round of the U.S. Open. Two clear of McIlroy.
Starting at the pin, but turning over way to the left.
A lot of Bermuda rough up on that left hillside. Oh, man. There is another look at this. It starts at the right side. That is something you don't see real often from Scottie Scheffler, the best ball striker on the PGA Tour this year, probably last year as well. That was an excellent break that he got over there.
Fifth major. Here at seven, Scheffler for his par. Just had to hit it. He had it on the line. That's going to be his first bogey today. All pars through six. Bogey here at seven. Thought he might have a tremendous amount of momentum left yesterday after he eagled 17, hold that fairway shot, and then birdied 18. Tee shot at 11 for Cam Smith. And makes it count. That is some birdie. 295 yards to the hole there today.
He's played in 15 U.S. Opens. He knows on a Sunday pars are pretty good scores, but not here. Now what John's talking about, he's going to break back. Just needed some more speed there. That was going to turn to the right at the end. He'll have another one of those tricky left to righties. Yep, that's Northern Irish for "are you kidding me?" He almost moved at impact. That's the first putt inside 7 feet this week that he missed. That was a 4-footer.
Slanted away from, so wants to kick the ball forward. Very tough to get it close.
Maybe on the fairway cut. No, he went for it. That's in that fescue. You just better look. Lie in the Bermuda. I went for the home run there, Paul.
Well, he had such a wild tee shot that he was forced to. You know, he decided at this point, I'm going to take a chance.
Come on, Rickie!
And being four behind. And now he just get out of here, you know, maybe a miracle chip.
Moment ago, Fowler got the ball back in his stance, going to hit this, chip it along the ground.
fortunate that he was able to get the club on the back of the ball cleanly.
I'm going to play some swing here, back to the right.
Got a chance. That really well played hole, though.
Just a little bit toward the center section of this fairway.
Wind off the right.
Wind's holding this up nicely. This is down the right side. Should be just fine.
Yeah, he was anxious there a little bit, Nody. You could see him, you know, giving it some body in this.
Real work.
Yeah, Rickie Fowler now. It's been 12 holes since making his 21st birdie. Hasn't made one since the 13th hole yesterday, and he's plus four in those 12 holes. He needs to start here. Oh, yeah. It's the kick you expect. It's like racing around turn three there, an ideal spot now. As long as it misses the divots, yep. That's fine.
Oh, no. He's tugged Black. This one. This has got to carry.
Oh. Nope, that's in the barranca. And that looks some high grass right there. Let's watch the end of this. This is coming down. Look at this angle.
Oh, man, that was close to being great.
Is that too much? Talking to it. Oh, what a shot.
Let's not forget.
Stop the club head. Oh, my goodness. Right under it, Zing.
Up and down for par.
I don't think he ever got the ball, Zing. All the way over the back of the green. Take a look at this, and you see the shaft slows down. That closes the club. This looks like a terrible lie. Hacked at it.
The short game can bail him out again.
That's nice. And Nody, you talked about a sports psychologist. Is that too much? Talking to it. Oh, what a shot.
Let's not forget.
7-9 from McIlroy. So you told me you could chip something or hit high and let the wind kill it.
This has to be a little chip.
Just chipped it. This is on a great line.
Yeah, kind of a little punch, abbreviated follow through there, and he's just right above the flag stick. So the McIlroy murmurs continue here, trying to propel this one a little closer to the hole.
Swinging really well to be able to chisel that 7-iron.
McIlroy has this for birdie. You can see the swing from right to left. Just touch it. Didn't get it out there enough. But it'll be a 3 for McIlroy. Who knows where he's going to end up after Clark's adventures over at the 8th.
Clark's likely to make double bogey now, and Rory will be tied for the lead with 9 holes to go at the U.S. Open, but he has struggled on the back 9. He's 2 over for the week.
The pressure of having the tee box. It's a 7-iron just to the right of it.
Just when you think Rickie was drifting out of the picture, he's right back in there, Zane.
Yes, he is right back in.
He's tugged. This wind might save him here, though.
No, too close to the edge, and I'm sure if that got down to the bunker, or is just in that rough.
He can't get this within 10 feet going to the left, I don't think. This was killed there. He's going to try to use this hill, but it's not going to do it.
Save, and you can see what it meant to Clark. Fist pump there as he makes the turn, still with the lead.